servant of the circumcised on behalf of the truth of God, in order that he might confirm the promises given to the patriarchs, and in order for the Gentiles might glorify God for his mercy. So Paul declares that the faithful promises of God that were given to the people of Israel in the Old Testament have and will continue to be fulfilled for all people. Not some, but all. He calls on passages of the Old Testament to provide certainty to the things he's speaking about. He provides us lots of examples from Scripture. He recounts a verse from 2 Samuel, from Deuteronomy, from two of the Psalms, and from Isaiah, and links them all together with this word again to increase the emphasis that there's one Scripture after another that points to what Paul is speaking about. Scripture passages that come from multiple prophets and authors. So he says, as it was written, from 2 Samuel, he says, therefore I will confess you among the Gentiles and sing praises to your name. He says, and again, rejoice, O Gentiles, with his people. That comes from Deuteronomy and Psalm 18. And he says, and again, praise the Lord, all you Gentiles, and let all the prophets praise him. That comes from Psalm 117. And again, Isaiah says, the root of Jesse shall come, the one who rises to rule the Gentiles. In him the Gentiles shall hope. That comes from Isaiah chapter 11. So God's promise is for all of us. God coming in the form of an infant boy was and is for all of us. Martin Luther, he summarized what Paul said. And Luther writes this. He says, Christ takes upon himself everything that separates us from God. Christ takes all of that on, and in return, gives us all of Christ's benefits. In exchange, this exchange is continually happening. This exchange is event. It's truth in our lives as we become and as we welcome neighbor and as we are welcomed, as we live in harmony with one another in accordance with Jesus Christ. So this is a continual thing that happens every day. It's not a one and done thing. It's a continuous thing. And he goes on to say, and because this is a liberating, hopeful, and happy exchange, we sing praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, and all people witness to God's glory. That's Martin Luther's take. Here's my 2019 take on what Paul is saying to our very fractured and polarized world today. When we invest ourselves in the Word of God, when we take time to do a daily devotion, and we take the time to read Scripture, God imparts truth and promise into our spirits through the power of the Holy Spirit. And that manifests itself in divine hope and joy in us that gives us the ability to live in harmony with one another. It gives us the ability, whether we choose to or not, that's a whole different human thing. But we're given the ability to do that, to live in true harmony with one another in community where God is praised in a unifying voice. And I'm not talking about a harmony that is superficially created through self-defined interests. What do I mean by that? Not a superficial harmony. When we join the clubs, a hockey club, quilting club, we have a defined interest. We have harmony because we're doing the same thing. We enjoy the same thing. We surround ourselves with